hour that the door is going to be open, Brother Josh. But you know what? I'm praising in the hallway. I'm not going to sit down. I'm not going to take a break just because God didn't move yet.
Come on.
You know what? He's looking for somebody. And I'm not lifting up myself. I'm coming to tell you tonight that God's looking for somebody to keep walking on His word.
Amen.
Walking on His word strongly and believingly.
Jesus.
Lord, have your way, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, bless
the
Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Right. I'll be walking around a many times, and I'll see a playground on a bunch of people.
Come on. Amen.
I'll see a swing going back and forth. The enemy and Jesus. Well, you know what? If you're not serving the Lord, you're serving the enemy. I don't care what you say. Jesus.
Yeah. Amen.
Come on.
Jesus or nothing.
Yes. That's right. Come on.
The Lord also, as I was talking to him about the message.
Yes, Jesus.
He began to deal with me on people saying, when you go down in Jesus' name, what does it say? You're coming up new.
Yeah. Come on.
So my own past is not there anymore.
Amen.
Come on.
When I was 12 years old, I struggled with ADHD, I was on a mood disorder, and I had depression. But you know what? When I got down and got real with God, Michelle, I didn't need any of that. I don't blame any of that.
Amen.
Because I've changed. Sister Christy, I've changed. God first. And God's looking for somebody to make it through there and praise our way through with a strong bone system.
Amen.
It's supposed to make you weak. But really, it's a strong, and who's going to shout on the other side?
Amen. Amen.
So yes, I'm coming Jesus. To tell you tonight that you got power over all the enemy. Yeah. And it's up to you whether you want to use it or not. And it's up to you on how effective it is.
That's right.
He can keep bothering you if you let him.
That's right.
So I want to encourage you, if you don't know what you're doing, if you feel like you're walking and the enemy's trying to deceive you, he could be just right around the corner and somebody else could just be watching you, not letting you fall. Or letting you fall.
Amen.
But I want to encourage you now to make a trip up to this altar.
Yeah, come on.
Come on.
To make a trip up to this altar and ask the Lord how your walk is.
Yes.
And where are you walking? And say, Lord, search me.
Yes. Amen.
If there's anything unclean, God, you begin to take it out.
Yes, Jesus.
Anything unholy, you begin to take it out.
Yes, Jesus.
So I encourage everybody or anybody that feels led to come up here and just let the Lord search you.
Come on.
If you need prayer, we'll pray with you.
Come on. Yes.
All right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good job.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Yeah. Hallelujah. Well, this altar is open. Josh is going to begin to play. But if you feel the Lord pulling at you, maybe you've been doing all you can do. Maybe you said, Lord, I'm trying. But you keep getting pulled in. Listen to me. He's always there to listen to you. He's always there to just put his arms around you and tell you how much he loves you. This altar's open. Say, search me, O Lord. Let me have a clean heart. Let me walk in your ways. Let me talk in your way. Let me be everything you had me to be. And when the enemy comes in like a flood, I know you'll raise up that standard against it. As they're praying, I want to share something with you. I woke up the other morning, and I felt the Lord so strong. My baby was asleep beside me, and I began to say, Lord, I just love you. I just want to love on you for a minute. I don't want nothing. I just want to love on you. And I felt him just put me in his arms. And I felt his love for me. And I began to cry and weep. And I looked over at my baby. And I said, God, if you can love me half as much as I love my children. Oh, I just praise you and I thank you for it. But the love that come into that room was a love that I've never felt before. I know that he was there. And he said, I'll always be there to pick you up. I'll always be there for you. But you just got to let me. Sometimes we just got to let him. Sometimes we just got to say, okay, God, I'm going to shut up. And I'm going to sit here and I'm just going to listen to you and I'm going to let you love on me. I'm going to let you teach me something. I'm just going to let you just talk. Because sometimes we do a little bit too much talking and not enough listening. But as he begins to play and we begin to just get into some worship, feel free to come to this altar. Because listen to me, it ain't never closed. His love and mercy's never dried up. It's always here. There's always salvation if you don't have salvation. You just got to come with a truly repentant heart. But maybe you just need a little closer walk. Come on, the altar's open. You need prayer for healing. We'll lay hands on you. We'll pray with you. We love you tonight.
Yeah. Jesus.